Let's take a look at creating this speaker grille cover. This was a question posted on the forum. This is not going to be an exact replica of what we see in the picture. Rather, we are going to focus on two main features. There is a grille pattern that covers the front face partially. There is also a circular cutout under the grille. Note that the interior face is completely smooth. We shall begin with this overall shape that was created using a loft. For this particular workflow, this solid body will represent the core of the final model. First, we are going to create a copy of this face. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Offset. Remove the Chain Selection option so that we can select faces individually. Select this face. Set the distance to 0. We are going to use this surface body later for the circular cutout. Let's hide this for the moment. Activate the Solid tab. Go to Modify, Shell. Select the bottom face of the body. Since this body represents the core of the final model, we need to set the shelling direction to outside. Adjust the thickness. You can think of this as creating a skin over the original body. I have prepared a sketch here that defines the grille pattern region. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Extrude. Select the sketch as a profile. Extrude this beyond the top face of the body. This surface body will act as a termination surface for one half of the grille pattern. I have sketched a single straight line on a plane offset from the right plane. Activate the Solid tab and begin the Extrude command. Select the Thin Extrude option. Select the line as a profile. For wall location, select Center. Adjust the thickness. Set the operation to cut. For extent type, select two objects and select the surface body from the bodies folder. It is important to select the whole surface body rather than a single face. In your own design, you want to make sure that the sketch line does not go above the termination surface. Otherwise, this will create an error during the extrude. Go to Create, Pattern, Rectangular Pattern. For object type, select Features and select the Thin Extrude. or axis, click on the select box and select the Z axis. Set distribution type to spacing. Adjust the quantity and spacing. Set the compute option to adjust. The patterned instances would honor the extent condition set during the first extrude and terminate up against the surface body accordingly. Right-click on the termination surface body to remove. We will not be needing this later. Go to Create, Mirror. For object type, set to Features. Select the first scene extrude and the rectangular pattern. Select the right plane as a mirror plane. After some testing, I have found that only the optimized compute option would give us the required result. Begin the fillet command. We want to create a full round fillet at the ends of each of these slots. We can certainly do this one at a time. Let's try using the power of rule fillets to do this more efficiently. Set type to rule fillet. For rule, select all edges. The ends of these slots were created by the first thin extrude, the rectangular pattern, and the mirror. So select these features from the timeline. For topology, select fillets only. This option adds material onto internal corners, as you can tell by the icon. Adjust the radius to get a full round. The command will seek out all internal corners produced by the three features and add material to these internal corners. The advantage of using rule fillets is that even if you change the number of instances of the rectangular pattern, the fillets will still be created accordingly, without you having to reopen a fillet feature and adding or removing the individual edges. Next, we need to round off these edges. This is going to be slightly more tricky. Begin the fillet command. Going by the same principles from the previous fillet, it might make sense to select the first extrude, the rectangular pattern, the mirror, and lastly, the newly created fillet. In this case, we need to remove material from the external corners. So set topology to rounds only. Adjust the radius. On first glance, this looks pretty good. But if we turn to the other side, we see that these inside edges have been rounded as well, which is not what we want. So we need another way to make the selection. Go back into the fillet feature. For rule, select between faces and features. Remove the selected features. For the first set, select these two faces. and also these faces. Click on the select box for the second set and select the first extrude, the rectangular pattern, and the mirror. The way to think about the selection process is to try and think about what are the faces and features that interacted together to create the edges that you need to fillet. So by bringing the top faces into the picture, we are able to limit the fillets to the top edges only. Let's bring back the surface body that we created at the beginning. Go to Create, Thicken. We want to thicken towards the outside. Adjust the thickness such that it is slightly below the grille pattern. The inside face of the thickened body flushes with the inside face of the shell. Right-click on the surface body to remove. Let's isolate the thickened body. I have prepared a circle sketch here on the top plane. Begin and extrude with this profile. For extent type, select all. Because this body has been isolated, the extrude does not cut into the shell. You can expand objects to cut to check. Let's unisolate the thickened body. Go to Modify, Combine. Shift select all bodies in the bodies folder and combine them into one. Looking at the inside, you might still notice these split lines even though the faces are flushed. This is sometimes a quirk of the combine command.